من دار البشائر من دار البشائر من دار البشائر
أيا صرحا يزوفنا البشائر من دار
من دار البشائر
متى نغنى خلائرنا وحرحا بغير الله والإيمان عميل
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
عمر بن العاص رضي الله عنه said, I fought against Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the battle of Badr and Allah saved me. And then I fought against Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the battle of Uhud and Allah saved me. And then I fought against Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the battle of Khandaq and Allah saved me. Now when is Amr ibn al-As saying this? He's saying this after he became Muslim. So now he's looking back at his memories and he's thinking about it and saying, man, I was fighting the Messenger of Allah. What in the world was I doing? I mean, then, being a mushrik, being a disbeliever, the way he would think about things is different. And now when he looks back at it, I mean, saying, wait a minute, I was fighting against the Messenger of Allah. And these are the Sahaba radiallahu anhum who loved Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than anything in the world. So after every battle he would say, and Allah saved me. Meaning if I died then, I would have been in hellfire. So he's going through his history. Said, I fought against Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Badr, and then I fought against him in Uhud, and then I fought against him in Al-Khandaq. And I was beginning to feel that no matter what, Muhammad is going to win. His armies are getting better and better. His da'wah is spreading more and more. And we are getting more constricted and narrowed in our movement day after day. So Amr ibn al-As was starting to feel this conflict and depression that a kafir would have when he sees the victory of Islam. I mean, there's so much built up envy, jealousy, hatred that builds up in the hearts of the kuffar. I mean, you have to keep in mind that shaitan is the one who's dominating the heart of the disbeliever. So all of these feelings are bottled up inside the heart of Amr ibn al-As. So he just had enough of it and he decided that he's going to leave Mecca and go and stay in a place called Al-Wahd. He took his family, he took his wealth, and he went there and he said, وَأَقْلَلْتُ مِنَ النَّاسِ. And I stayed away from people. He just wanted to stay away from everyone. And then when Al-Hudaybiyah, when the contract of Al-Hudaybiyah occurred, when Quraysh were forced to admit the existence of the Islamic State and they were forced to admit the authority of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I mean, when some of the Sahaba complained about Uhud, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam reminded them about the days of Uhud, the early days of Islam, and he told them, now Quraysh have accepted peace from you. He was turning their attention to the development, the great developments that were occurring. And we said that Al-Hudaybiyah was a great victory for Islam. So Al-Hudaybiyah, when it happened, Amr ibn al-As, he said, tomorrow Muhammad will enter into Mecca. It's inevitable. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is going to come in. If it reached to the degree that Quraysh have been unable to fight him when he's at the doorsteps of Mecca, and they accepted to sign a treaty with him, this is a sign of the fact that sooner or later, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will enter into Mecca. So he ruled out staying in Mecca and he ruled out staying in Al-Ta'if. And these are the two major cities of Al-Hijaz. He called some of the members of his clan, and Amr ibn al-As was a man who was respected among his people. And they used to listen to him and they used to see him as being their guide. So he called these people who had trust in him and he told them, إِنِّي أَرَى أَمْرَ مُحَمَّدٍ يَعْلُ الْأُمُورَ كُلَّهَا عُلُوًّا مُنْكَرًا. I can see that the affair of Muhammad is rising above all others in a horrible way. I mean, he's seeing the events unfolding in front of his eyes, and through his wisdom and intelligence he can read through these events and history and see that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Islam are slowly but surely rising and rising and rising against everything else. I can see this with my own eyes. And he's a disbeliever, but he can sense and feel that. He can see it. Just like some of the kuffar today can see it, while unfortunately many of the Muslims are failing to see it. And they are deep in their sleep. And they cannot see what is happening and unfolding of the events of the Ummah today. And they are failing to see the victory of Allah Azza wa Jal that is on its way. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا.